Yeah, I thought, you know, really poor start. I thought we were really anxious early. Came out, missed some opportunities offensively to move the chains and start getting in a rhythm, which really, you know, it hurt us and, you know, got us out of momentum and basically didn't get us in rhythm, I guess. And just real antsy early on. You know, we had defensively early on had way too many missed tackles. You know, I just thought overall it was a slow start. We got to settle in better than that. We got to have the confidence early to go out there and understand that we can make big plays and we can be explosive. You know, I thought defensively we played timid. I thought offensively at times we played timid. Special teams weren't much better. And so, you know, I think that's really the first half. Second half, I thought offensively we came out and finally got the mindset to where we're not going to be stopped and we're going to play like we know how we can. And I thought our guys started making some plays. Thought we started running the ball well, knocking people off the ball. Thought we hit some explosive plays in the pass game once our quarterback got settled in. Defensively, I thought they came out and they had a four-play stop on a four-down territory, or excuse me, on four downs. You know, I just think we had a much better second half. Obviously, you're not going to beat a team like that when you're minus two in turnovers, all the missed tackles we had. You know, just didn't play well enough. You got to give SMU a lot of credit. I think they're really explosive offensively. They had a veteran quarterback that knows how to manage it very well. You know, but we'll just we got to get back on the tape and rebound and make sure that we gain the confidence needed each and every week to go out there and play ball. And that's what it comes down to.
Is it just a tough way for a rivalry game to go? You talked about the importance of it earlier in the week. You know, school you see why, or school you recruit against. Is that just a tough way to have that happen?
Yeah, it's not. I mean, you never want to get caught behind like that that early in the game. And you know, it's tough. I mean, there's no doubt. It's always an important game to us. And, you know, we have to have the right mindset, understanding we can go out there and play with them and beat them. And I just didn't feel like, we did enough early on to give ourselves that opportunity against a really good football team. We were going to have to play well tonight. We knew it. And I don't think we played as well as we could have in the first half.
Do you feel like the amount of youth and kind of less experienced players on both sides of the ball kind of led to that?
Well, I mean, you have a lot of young players. You have some, you know, a couple. I'll tell you what, I was really proud of Kyle Powell. I mean, shoot, he's playing fullback a week ago. Moved him over to the defensive side of the ball. And to play as much as he did, he played extremely hard. Probably wasn't always in the right spot, but thought he did a heck of a job. Kevin Wood, thought he did a great job of filling in as well. And so our depth was a big issue tonight. You know, a lot of different places just because of some of the stuff that's going on. But again, you're going to play young guys. That's what we have a young team, and those veterans have to play like veterans, and the young guys have to grow up quick and have to gain that confidence quick. And so, you know, we as coaches got to put them in good situations to have that success. And they, when they go out there, they got to feel like Superman when they're out there playing.
The defense really struggled, you know, for the second straight week. Is there something you can pinpoint there, or is it just the guys you're missing tonight?
Well, I mean, that certainly doesn't help. You miss your two best players probably on defense. But at the same time, we're not making excuses. We just got to get better. You know, Coach Bowen, I believe in Coach Bowen. I believe in that staff, and I know they're going to make the right corrections. I believe in our defensive kids. I think we have good talent. We just got to continue to settle into the system, figure out what we're really good at, and figure out what we're not really good at, and try to – all you can do is get better at this point and just – again, just settle into the system and keep making those corrections. It'll come.
Talk about a little bit about Oscar's breakout performance. Last first game, he had over 100 yards. This game, he has over 100. What would you attribute those two performances to, and what you've seen?
His mindset. When he goes out there, I mean, he runs hard, gets his pads down low. He's a big guy that can, you know, he's powerful enough to run through you, and he's athletic enough to run around you. And so he realizes that. He understands when to utilize it. And, you know, I think a lot of it, though, is his mindset. He has a confidence about himself, which is what you have to have if you're going to play this game. And, you know, you just see it when he's running the ball, his passion. And, you know, I've seen it a ton throughout, you know, I've said it. I wish we could have got him some more opportunities this past year, but he had an injury there late in the year to where we couldn't. We were trying to save him for those last games. But I've been excited about the way he's been running. He needs to continue to do that. But, again, we have a deep running back group that all those guys need to. And, you know, we'll all get better.
What was the story with Trey Sanders tonight?
I don't talk about things like that. I mean, it has nothing to do with him not. He had a little injury, so I'm not going to go any further than that with HIPAA stuff.
Did SMU defensively catch y'all up on anything early on, or
I'm sorry.
Did SMU's defense do anything early on that maybe caught y'all off guard or anything like that?
Nothing. Did the same things. That, you know, again, we've seen on tape. You know, it was rolling a bunch of cover three strong, 3 week, Tampa two, and a little bit of man on third downs. It's nothing that we haven't seen on tapes, nothing we haven't worked against. We just got to execute. And, again, you have to give them credit for that. I'm not taking that away because they're a really good football team.
You mentioned that they're really good. I mean, Michelle had another great game against you guys. Is he just a special talent?
He's a really good football player. You know, he's experienced. He understands, you know, the system he's running. I think he has a lot of playmakers around him. Their running backs run hard. And then you got one really physical one, and then you got one that can take it to the house at any point. If you miss a tackle, he can make you pay. I think the receivers are great route runners. They can make you pay in the pass game. They're explosive. Not only that, when they catch the ball, they can make you miss in space. And so they're a talented team. And again, we knew that coming in. Obviously, we got to play much better in order to compete with a team of their caliber.
With Houston coming up next week, do you feel like this, I don't want to say it's a wake-up call, but just any takeaways from this game going into Houston?
Well, I think offensively, he's come out with a frame of mind like he did in the second half to where, you know, you're getting that first down, you're getting in rhythm, you're moving the chains, and then everything starts to open up from there. You can be explosive. Defensively, we got to make sure we tackle better. We got to make sure our eyes and our fundamentals continue to get better. And, you know, we got to have some moxie about us. And that's overall as a team, that's something that that's what we need to do. And I feel, again, like we have a very talented team. It's just a matter of making sure as coaches we put them in the right spots. And as players, when we do, make sure you go out there and you have to execute and make plays.
How good did it feel to see Austin get a little bit of confidence on the offense for the second half of the game, where the last game it was Jason who started to get more reps and lead the offense a little bit more efficiency? How did it feel to see Austin do that this time around?
It's great to see. I mean, you can see it in practice and with both those guys. And, you know, I think they've both actually had a really good 2 weeks. So I was a little surprised, you know, the uneasiness early. But that's part of it. That's my job as the coach to make sure we get them comfortable. And, you know, but they're only going to gain confidence as it goes. You know, I think last week it was Bean, this week it was Ani. But, you know, if they come out and start the way they finish, we're going to be fine.